Hi, I'm Christian Meyer, founder of the online Python Academy Pfingster.com, doctoral researcher in the area of computer science, and author of two Python textbooks. In the next 60 minutes, you're going to learn my exact strategy how to earn $3,000 per month as a Python freelancer without actually working full-time and without sacrificing time with your family. At the end of this webinar, you will not only know the exact steps you need to perform to become a well-paid Python freelancer, but I will also give you the link to my free PDF Python textbook. So stick around if you like the idea of working part-time as a Python freelancer, receiving a full-time income. I know there are so many distractions around us, but this webinar may change the course of your life to the better. It's about you taking control about your income and your business. So switch off Facebook, close Reddit for now, and give me your full attention. Especially in the US, but also in Europe, many people are broke. What is broke? You don't have any leftover money to account for special circumstances. The average debt of college students is $27,225. But is debt really a problem? The popular consultant Dan Lok, he calls himself the world's highest paid consultant, has a somehow different view on debt. Let me read one of his statements for you. You don't have a debt problem, you have an income problem. You don't have an income problem, you have a skill problem. Because if you are skilled, you can always sell your services at a higher rate. Suppose there are two employees, Bob and Alice. Bob has $10,000 in assets and a yearly income of $31,524. Bob is debt-free, so many people would consider Bob's financial state as convenient, when in fact he is broke. Alice, on the other hand, has an inconvenient $100,000 in debt. But Alice can sell her skills at a rate of $131,000 per year. What happens after 2 years? Alice can easily outsave Bob by tens of thousands of dollars, even if she starts with a lot of debt. You can also see this scenario on the right-hand figure. The higher the skills, the more you can expect to earn. Do you actually know how much money you currently earn? An average employee works for 1,811 hours per year. As an employee, it is very hard to earn more than $90,000. In fact, the median wage of all workers in the US is $24 per hour. For example, if you are a student, you are earning minus $4 per hour. School teachers, on the other hand, earn $37 per hour. If you push yourself very hard and become an extremely skilled employee, you might become a university professor with a yearly salary of $98,423. This is $54 per hour. First, know your hourly wage. Second, improve it. So, how to increase your value to the marketplace? This webinar and the associated course has two goals. First, creating a new high-income skill for you, Python development. Second, show you how and why to switch the road from being full-time employee to being at least part-time self-employed. On the left graphic, you can see the hourly wage of different employees as introduced previously. On the right graphic, you can see the income distribution of Python freelancers. The median wage of a Python freelancer is $51 per hour. Let me repeat this. The median wage of a Python freelancer is $51 per hour. This means that an average self-employed Python freelancer easily reaches the income level of a university professor. Think about this. Can you become a university professor? It's totally up to you to answer this question, but you can certainly become an average skilled Python freelancer, can't you? You are probably wondering why I am qualified to teach you this topic. Let me quickly introduce myself so that we can go to a more personal level. I'm currently in a transition phase from being an employed doctoral researcher working at the university in Germany for maybe $24 per hour to becoming self-employed in the Python education sector. My research included processing large graph data sets like the web document graph. However, for a few months now, I have parental leave, caring about my two children. In the evenings and weekends, I create courses, write books, like my newest book, Coffee Break Python, and create code puzzles for my Python learning app, Thinkster.com. Why do you want to become a Python freelancer? How would your life look like if you only needed to work part-time as a Python freelancer doing projects you love? I have already stressed the first point. Imagine you work from home and see your kids growing up and having the flexibility to spend more quality time with your wife or husband. But there's also an equally important point if you need to take care of your family, and that is, you can increase your value to the marketplace. And there's virtually no upper limit of your hourly rate. If you are an employee, you basically have an upper limit. You have seen that a professor earns $53 per hour. But if you have seen many freelancers, including myself, earning $100 to $200 per hour. It all depends on how expensive you can make yourself to the marketplace. For some of my students, being a Python freelancer is also a lifestyle choice. For example, one of my students is successfully employed in the US and earns good money there. But his dream is to go back to India to his family working as a Python freelancer. Doing this, he earns dollars and pays rupees for his living expenses. Why not enjoying the benefits of globalization? It's also good to diversify your income streams. You could spend one day per month to earn $400 to $500 per month as an additional income that you can spend for you or your family, or even save it for later. Finally, being a Python freelancer is also a lot of fun. You have to stretch your abilities regarding Python, but also regarding soft skills such as communication ability and language skills. If you are not a native speaker, like me, it's very nice to improve your skills that way, while you are getting paid for doing good work for other people. Can you already see yourself working as a Python freelancer? There are basically three ways of becoming a Python freelancer. The first is being a consultant, working for a big company. The second is to be a freelancer working on a platform such as Upwork or Fiverr, doing mostly smaller tasks. The third option is to create your own platform that you own. For example, creating your own website and drive traffic to it. I call it the hybrid approach because you have some elements of both previous options. Now we will go a bit deeper into each of these options. The first way of becoming self-employed is to work for one or a few big clients as a consultant. Working as a consultant has some advantages. You work in a business-to-business setting, which allows you to tap into large earning potentials. There is a lot of money in business-to-business, especially if you focus on high-ticket sales. However, many people I know working as consultants heavily rely on one or two big clients. They are not diversified at all. And if you work for a single big company, you will have very limited freedom in terms of your projects and working conditions. Many Python consultants report that the pressure is hard and it feels like working as an employee. This is not the focus of this course, however. So if you prefer to work as a consultant, I would not recommend that you take this specific course. The second way, and this is the focus of this webinar and also the course that comes with this webinar, is to sell your services as a Python freelancer on some existing freelancing platforms such as Upwork or Fiverr. Basically, these platforms are very, very convenient. You could start today creating your freelancing account and start with your first gig in the evening. Then you solve the jobs, which takes maybe a week or even only a day. You are very flexible, you can learn fast and without too much pain or commitment. Also, you have this small feedback cycle. You can go over the whole cycle of acquiring a client, doing the work, finishing the job and getting reviewed. Over time you will become an expert in the soft skills and communication part, and you will learn about many different areas where your Python skills can help people out. It's a perfect option of getting a foot in the door and to converge job by job to your final specializations, in case you want to specialize to increase your earning potential on the freelancing market. Also, there is no startup overhead. Marketing is simple. We will learn later that you need to have two things, an attractive profile and good ratings. Of course, nothing is perfect. When working as a Python freelancer, you don't own the platforms. You don't own the clients. As a default, if you don't do anything against it, later we will see that you can also acquire the clients from the platform and creating your own database of clients to mitigate this last point. Also, these platforms get their significant cut of 25% for each job. That's quite something. So overall, working as a freelancer on these platforms is all about getting testimonials, skills, and expertise. Finally, the third option is also the one with the highest income potential. You can create your own platform, for example, setting up a WordPress page where you offer your details and service offerings. You retain 100% of the control over your income, your projects, and even your testimonials. The sky is the limit. You can earn hundreds of dollars per hour, if you're smart about it. However, there's also the need for you to market your services. You need to install a marketing funnel. For example, you attract potential customers using Facebook ads, set up a landing page with a lead magnet so that they are motivated giving you your email addresses. Then you will nurture your leads, sending them tons of value and build a relation to them. While this seems to be complex, it is definitely the strategy I would recommend in the long term. However, in the short term, it's much better for most people to gain experiences and testimonials on the freelancing platforms and then gradually shift their focus towards their own platform as they get to know more and more clients. So these are the three options. This webinar and the associated course focus on the second option as a starting point. In this webinar, you learn how to go full-time as a Python freelancer without actually working full-time. The success formula is simple. You start working as a Python freelancer now, no matter your current skill level, then you keep increasing your value to the marketplace until you have reached at least average Python freelance level. At this point, you will charge $51 per hour. Would you consider a daily income of $100 as a full-time income? According to US statistics, earning $3,000 per month is already above the median salary. Now the plan is to work for 2 hours on your core freelancing activities. The rest of your time, you are free to spend with your family, for rest, learning, or even finding better freelancing jobs. That's it. The strategy is simple, but nonetheless effective. It provides you a clear and manageable path to your new freelancing lifestyle. How can you increase your value to the marketplace such that you can easily work average Python freelancing level? You can see the fortress. Our client sits in the fortress and you need the magic key to enter it. What's the key? Next, I will give you 3 secrets how you can unlock the gates and connect with your clients. First, use research insights of psychology to build trust. Second, become a specialist rather than a generalist. Third, leverage network effects. We will explore all 3 secrets in the next 3 slides. The key is to earn trust and to be attractive. Clients pay more and you will get the better jobs if you are trustworthy and attractive to them. On the graphic, I have searched for the keyword Python at the Upwork freelancing platform. 2 out of 3 freelancers at the top have a 100% job satisfaction rate. They will always get the job. So how to earn trust? You collect positive ratings. The more ratings you have, the better. And the better the rating, the better as well. If you buy properties in the real estate sector, it's all about location. Trust me, in the freelancing sector, it's all about ratings. You need to engineer your ratings. If you have good ratings, you will always find jobs, no matter how good your external achievements are. You don't even need an academic degree. You can find the best jobs if you have good ratings. With good ratings, you will always find good, well-paid and attractive jobs. So rating is king. How to actually get good ratings? We have seen that good ratings are important. There are three basic ways. The first is communication. Be very responsive. Be very positive. Be a yes man and be generous with your offers. Second, have a lot of Python skills. And this is the focus of this talk. The third way is to always over-deliver. If your task is to give him 100 Python puzzles and you send him 110 Python puzzles, you can almost be sure to get the 5-star rating on the platform. You not only delivered what he, the client, asked you for, but over-delivered the task. This is a simple but effective 3-step way to get great ratings. Then, this is a very important and underestimated point, the reciprocity rule. If you give something away, the receiving person will feel the obligation to give back to you. That's why they have free food in supermarkets. I have hired many freelancers for my website, Pfingster.com, and some of them were really smart. When applying for the project, they just gave me something for free. For example, the project was develop 100 Python puzzles, and they just gave me 1 to 3 Python puzzles for free. I was feeling the strong urge to give back to those freelancers by hiring them. I even wanted to hire all of them to not miss out on giving back to them. This is a powerful mindset. Give first, then you will receive. Finally, on some platforms like Upwork, you can complete small Python tests. Certificates also go a long way building trust with your clients. If you complete the associated Python course, you will also be able to download unlimited certificates on the Python learning app, Pfingster.com. There are other tricks that will impact your success on these platforms. One is the specificity of your skill set. The more specific, the better and the more trustworthy. So secret number 2 is money flows to specialists. If you just sell your services telling them I can program any Python program you need, then they will not really trust you that you are the expert in any Python field. But if you tell them that you are the go-to expert for anything regarding Python Django authentication, then they will definitely go for you if they need just that. You are honest and authentic about your specific skill set. This signals confidence and expertise to these clients. What are the skills that the marketplace seeks? There are some foundations which any good Python freelancer must master. These are basic and complex data types, lambda functions, list comprehension, complexity of data structure access, basic algorithms, keywords, and so on. Knowing about the foundations already qualifies you doing Python freelancing jobs. However, if you want to increase your earning potential, you need to specialize in more advanced knowledge areas. Examples are machine learning, data analysis, web scraping, or web development. For example, Django. Each of these areas consists of subtopics like scikit-learn, regression analysis, NumPy, etc. In each of these specializations, you become more focused toward this specific area, which automatically increases your value to the client. But an important observation is also that every specialization builds upon a solid foundation. So don't be lazy and skip the foundations. Finally, just to motivate you again that it's all about rating, secret number 3 is to leverage network effects. In the internet, there is a rule: the winner takes it all. The rich get richer and the popular people get even more popular. If you are already winning on these platforms, you will win even more. People tend to simply reinforce the decisions of their peers. If all of them gave you 5 stars, most clients will simply default to giving you 5 stars as well. This network effect is a well-researched phenomenon in all kinds of networks like social, the web, and also freelancer rating networks. There are 2 basic tactics that you can use to leverage this information to earn more money and increase your value to the marketplace. First, focus on your initial jobs. See your initial jobs as investments in your future. Even if you did them for free, and I'm not advocating this, They will be profitable in the future by attracting the better jobs and clients. Second, you should prefer many small jobs over a few large jobs, because this way you will gain your credibility faster. Many people subconsciously have the simple heuristic, more jobs means more ratings, which means you are a better freelancer. How much skills do you need before starting with your freelancing career? And the short answer is to just start now and figure out how to solve the problems as you go. You will be paid for your learning time. I have annotated the income scale of Python freelancers with the Python levels you can have. As you can see, if you are just beginning with your Python career, you will of course earn less, but you will still earn something. Make a lot of experiences and gain practical insights into what to learn and where to learn and where your knowledge gaps are. The long answer for a perfectionist, of course, is to master the basics in Python first, if you don't feel confident. You can already specialize on a Python topic, and to gain even more confidence, you can even do some toy projects. One of my secret tips for learning to freelance in Python is to learn with archived freelancing projects. You can already gain practical experience and learn the type of projects that people have paid freelancers for. Still, I would always recommend to just start doing real Python projects and then put in all the effort to earn your 5-star rating and to overdeliver. My recommendation is that you use a personal training plan which has a very practical focus. You divide your time into two blocks. One block takes 70% of your learning time. You use this time to work on practical Python projects, which can be archived freelancing Python projects that challenge you to go to higher levels. You could even spend this learning time on your dream projects. This is even better because it keeps you highly motivated and engaged. The key is to not stop working on these until you have successfully finished them and created a minimum viable product. The rest of your time, 30%, you will invest in solving Python puzzles, work through Python courses, read Python books. You can see that this is a highly practical approach. I'm talking about your learning time, which is mainly practical. The reason is that for any subject you want to acquire or even master, you need to have the practical motivation. You need to open your knowledge gap to see what you don't know before stuffing things in your brain. Ask any expert on Quora. They will tell you that practice first is the best way to learn Python fast. There's no shortcut. On the theoretical part, I recommend solving Python puzzles as a main lever for your personal improvement. Python puzzles are a powerful tool to become more and more proficient in reading and understanding Python's source code. What's a Python puzzle? A Python puzzle is an educative snippet of Python's source code that teaches a single computer science concept by activating the learner's curiosity and involving them in the learning process. The Python puzzles range from easy to complex. Each puzzle will push your theoretical and practical code understanding skills one step further. The puzzle-based learning method is very effective and proven by tens of thousands of online students. I give you a bit of time solving these two puzzles. If you feel challenged, this course is for you. So let's move on to the next slide. How would your life change if you developed a high income skill Python to become a Python freelancer? In this webinar, I have shown you a simple way out of the rat race of working 8 hours a day, 5 days a week for 40 years. In the follow-up course, Reach Python Skill Level in Your Coffee Breaks, I will give you a detailed training plan such that you can start earning money with your Python skills. I show you a new way of becoming a Python expert that is fun, that challenges you to reach higher levels of code understanding and that gives you a highly practical tool for developing and sharpening your new high-income skill Python. The course is packed with more than 100 code puzzles, videos, quizzes and cheat sheets. At the end of the course, you will be able to sell your skills on the marketplace, earning back your course investment many times over. To help you start earning money at the freelancing platforms Upwork and Fiverr, on the side or full-time, doesn't matter, I will give you a small Python task where you will earn $25 and your first 5-star rating. You know how invaluable this rating can be to find follow-up jobs and to kickstart your success on Upwork or Fiverr. Plus, I will give you your personal freelancing ad on a job board on my blog with more than 10,000 visitors per month. The testimonials from my 33,000 online students have been amazing. Danielle told me, as a fellow educator and fellow former PhD student, I just wanted to let you know that I'm really impressed with your teaching materials. You're doing a really great job. Rochen argues, I'm learning Python this semester as part of my degree and I found your way of explaining things way better than my professors. Well, at least it works for me. Travis said, I've been persistent in getting down the basics. Your puzzles help me understand and appreciate the logic that goes into coding. And Thomas said, I've been enjoying the website so far and it's been a great help in learning Python. Mio added, I have never learned so deeply. You are awesome. This course is for you if you want to take control of your finances and increase your earning potential. You will invest 60 minutes per day for 2 months to build your new high income skill. I have to admit, if you cannot even do this, you won't get satisfactory results. So don't take the course if you don't want to increase your earning potential, you don't want to spend time and effort being your own boss, or you want to watch Netflix instead of learning Python. I'm so sure about the success of this program that I offer you an unusual guarantee. My wife keeps telling me that it's crazy, but I am so confident that I can deliver the promise of pushing you to Python freelance level that I keep the guarantee in the course. Okay, what's the guarantee? First of all, I have a 30-day, no questions asked, money-back guarantee. Within the first 30 days, you can check out the course and simply ask for your money back. It is not working for you? No problem. Take your money back. On top of that, I have an additional bonus plus 30-day money back guarantee. So the total guarantee is 60 days. The guarantee is simple. You have followed the simple training plan which I provide you. You have earned your $25 on the freelancing platform working a simple Python gig for me, and you have solved at least 30 puzzles on my online app, on which, by the way, you will become a premium member by applying to this course. If you are still not able to earn at least $20 per hour as a Python freelancer, you get all your money back and keep your $25, the training plan, 2 of my Python ebooks, and everything you have learned so far. How do you like this guarantee? There is literally no risk involved for you. And I guarantee you that you will know after 60 days whether this course works for you or not. My number one priority of this course is to deliver results to you. To help you get freelancing jobs, I have reserved a limited number of advertising spots on my website where you can promote your freelancing services. If you would want to buy the ad space on my blog, it would cost you $1,200 per year. But you as a course member will get a primary ad space on my website for a year, 100% for free. Of course, ad space is scarce, so I will close this offer after having filled all positions. In summary, here's what you get if you join the course. Most importantly, You will sharpen and improve your high income skill Python and increase your value to the marketplace. You will get lifetime access to the course material, including Python puzzles, videos, cheat sheets, and a freelancer tutorial. You will become a lifetime premium member on my popular Python learning website, Pfingster.com. As a premium member, you can solve unlimited puzzles and download unlimited certificates to prove your skills to your employer or freelancing clients. You will get both my Python ebooks, Coffee Break Python and Coffee Break Python Slicing. You earn the right to join my Python Mastermind group on Facebook, where you have the opportunity to connect to other highly ambitious Python learners and freelancers. You can share tips and get help from other students. You get your personal training plan as a Google spreadsheet, where you can check your progress every day. It is a clear path to mastery, which will save you from wasting your learning time, having lost your focus. You get your first guaranteed freelancing job, if you want. This alone can be so valuable to earn your money back by getting better and higher paid freelancing jobs. And for a limited time, you will get the opportunity to advertise your services on my website with a yearly value of $1,200. The total value of all these benefits is $2,233. I offer this package, however, for a regular price of $600. But the price today is only $300 plus taxes. If you decide for a monthly payment plan of 4 to 24 payments, that's cheaper than a coffee a day. So take this opportunity now. Take control of your life and your income as a Python freelancer. Follow my course. Visit bit.ly/python-freelancer. There's no risk considering the unusual 60-day money-back guarantee. Thanks for joining this webinar. I had a lot of fun talking about your future as a Python freelancer. I wish you all the best and good luck on your exciting path of learning the Python high income skill. See you soon.